Sign got here. TPW.
Yes.
Bring in.
Yes.
Welcome to the corner.
Thank you. Always a pleasure.
Well, this time we get to sit down. We get to discuss a little bit about your future, which you just now entered.
Future. Yes.
Well, you've been only like 2 months now to a month actually wrestling.
Actually, in the ring, in front of crowds, I would say about a month now.
A month. And tonight you get your shot at gold early in your career.
Yes, I do, and it's exciting. I'm very excited.
So, how did you get started in wrestling? Why? All that kind of good stuff.
What really got me started in wrestling was when I was little. I would go over to my grandparents' house, and occasionally my grandfather would have the big companies on TV. He'd be watching wrestling on TV. And I remember as a kid crawling up in the bed with him, curling up in his lap, and falling asleep on his chest watching wrestling. Unfortunately, I lost my grandfather back in 2004. He was always one of my biggest supporters, one of the ones who always told me that whatever you want to do, you can do it. If you think you can do it, I believe in you, you can do it. He was one of the ones who supported me 100% no matter what I thought I wanted to do. Even if I thought I wanted to do it, I tried it and I didn't really like it as much as I thought. He was like, it's not for you, don't do it. So that was when I was probably about 5 or 6 when I still remember doing that with him. Didn't really get into it until I was about 13, I guess, and I really started watching full-time. I fell in love with the athleticism, the fact that they told a story with this athletic ability, this amazing athletic ability. You know, I was always an athlete in high school, and I was in everything. Sports, band, drama club, I mean, you name it, I did it. And the two things that I really wanted to do were the sports and the drama. And I saw wrestling was the perfect way to marry them. So I started looking into wrestling schools in the area. At the time, I could not afford it. Plain and simple, I couldn't afford to pay the fees to go train. So I went to college for a little while, moved home when my grandfather got ill. He passed away, I just never got back in. Finally, about a year ago, Johnny Mantel had the German Fest Ringmeisterschaft tournament, mm-hmm. which, being from the area, I knew Munster. I've been to the German Fest many times. You can't live in the area and not go to German Fest. I actually did not know about the tournament when I went to German Fest. I got in, went and got a couple drinks, was walking around, and I heard the sounds of wrestling. I was determined that I was going to go find it. I said, I have to go see. I've never been to a live event like this. You know, I've been to a couple WWE shows, you know, one or two big shows, a house show for TNA, but I'd never been to an independent show. And so I was like, I gotta see this. I gotta see, you know, I can get up close and personal, really feel it. I have to go see. So I spent all day Saturday at the ring. Mm-hmm. I watched all the matches. And that's where I met for the first time Tim Storm, mm-hmm. Kevin Douglas, mm-hmm. Chaz Taylor, mm-hmm. Tugboat Taylor, DJ King, Sean Hambone. Mm-hmm. I met all those guys there for the first time. The next month, you know, I had seen the advertising for TPW. I decided, hey, this is pretty cool. If they're involved with this, I want to go to the show. So I went to Fight Time Fitness. They were working, TPW was working with Fight Time Fitness because they were having their shows in the buildings there. Mm-hmm. And so Teresa and Mike West were helping sell tickets. And so I went to go pick up tickets for me and a couple friends. And I ended up taking a tour of Fight Time Fitness and actually signed up for a membership there at the same time. And so at the same time I was going to these wrestling shows, watching, I was also training kickboxing, boxing, jiu-jitsu, and MMA. And so I trained with Mike and Teresa from May, I guess it was, until December of that year. I went and competed at two NAGA events. NAGA is North American Grappling Association. I competed at the Southwest Regionals and placed second in my weight division, and that was in September. Placed second in my weight division, at the Southwest Regionals. And then December, I competed at the World Competition and placed second again. So big ups to Michael and Teresa. You guys are awesome. I love you. I don't know if you're watching this or not, but I love you guys, and I would not be where I am today without you guys. You guys help me out so much. Thank you. I owe you. After the German Fest, the next show, TPW, Chaz was working it. Chaz, DJ, Silky Banes was here, Hambone was here, Genelise was here, a bunch of the guys from Houston. And that's when I actually really got to start talking to Chaz. Like, I'd met him, and he kind of remembered my face from German Fest, but I really got to start talking to him then. And, you know, I told him how much I'd loved it growing up. And he's like, well, I've got a wrestling school down in Houston. He said, you're more than welcome to come check it out, see if it's for you, whatnot. So he and I talked over the next few months, and I kept going to the shows. I started helping with the ring setup here at TPW. Ring setup, tear down. I started working security for him. And then in August, I went down to Houston for the first time. I just thought I was going to be watching the guys work out. So I show up in my jeans and t-shirt, ready to watch and have a good time and just talk to everybody. Chaz pulls up and he goes, what are you doing? I said, I'm here to watch. He goes, you're not watching, you're getting in the ring. So needless to say, I was quite shocked. Luckily, I thought ahead and I did have a change of clothes to work out in. So I went and changed, got in the ring. First thing he had me do was a three-quarter roll from corner to corner. Luckily, we had done those in jiu-jitsu, so I knew what I was doing. Got in there, did it right the first time, and he was impressed. He said that that's a lot of times that's hard for people to get. So the fact, you know, my athletic background, the jiu-jitsu background, the boxing, the kickboxing, everything helped me, you know, has helped me transition into wrestling. So from August through December, I would go down to Houston once a month. I'd go down on a Thursday, have a training session, go to the show on Friday, stay Thursday night and Friday night in Houston, come home on Saturday. And from the first time I got in there, did that first roll, took that first bump, I knew that this is what I wanted to do. And Chaz and Tug and all the guys at Taylor's Pro Wrestling Factory have been so supportive. Like, I was worried about being that far from home because I'm big on family. My family means everything to me. And just being that, I've never lived 6 hours away from home. You know, the first I've lived is an hour away from my family. Being 6 hours away from home, Chaz and Tug and all the guys down there have just gone out of their way to make me feel part of the family.
Nice.
Yeah, it's meant a lot to me. You know, Chaz is like the big brother. Tug's like everybody's father. You know, Genelise has become like my sister. You know, and all the guys, everybody there on the Houston roster has just made it really welcoming and really, like, sometimes you go someplace and you kind of feel standoffish when you're a new person. Never once did I feel that standoffishness.
Yes.
It was always welcome with open arms.
Nice. So tonight, if by some chance, a miracle, no offense, there's a lot
of
veterans.
I have a lot of cards. The cards are stacked against me. I'm the rookie.
Yes.
You know, in this tournament, I'm the underdog. I mean, look at who you've got on the card. You've got Genelise, a multiple-time champion.
Mm-hmm.
Barbie Hayden, multiple-time champion. The Star Venus, she's been champion multiple times.
Pink,
Star
champion.
Venus, Pink, you know, the Angel Blue, the current Joshi champion at ACW.
I mean,
the talent on this card.
Torres.
Erica Torres. I mean, it just, the talent on this card, just in the women's division, is astronomical.
Yes. But by some chance, you do make it, and you do walk out. What's the first thing you're
going to
do?
My dad and my mom are going to be here tonight to watch me. The first thing I would have to do is definitely give them a big hug. Because my mom and dad, my mother and father divorced when I was young. I grew up with my mother. Didn't have the greatest relationship with my father. But since I turned 16 and I've gotten a little bit more freedom... You know, when you turn 16, you know, you can drive yourself around, you can go do what you want as long as, you know, you're home by a certain hour, you know. he and I started getting a lot closer, and the last, I'd say the last 4 years, we've really, really gotten really close. And he's, when I told him I wanted to start training, he was the one that said, you can do it. My mom that's going to be here tonight is actually my stepmother, who she's been right there with my dad, supporting me, pushing me to be my best, you know, just like what parents should. So they're going to be here tonight, and definitely the first thing I'm going to do is jump that rail and go give my dad a big hug.
Well, thank you for stopping by. I know you're going to be on the corner several more times.
Oh, yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Breanne.